Hello, it's Kevin Bacon again. This is part three, and we're actually going to get started building a prototype. I hope to have this prototype completed tomorrow, and then build the final stove on Thursday or Saturday, however it works. We're going to start out with a piece of 3.5-inch exhaust pipe. I'm going to use what was a helium tank for balloons and an R22 tank for the prototype. And then we're going to need some hardware and stuff, but that's where we're going to start with these three items. I need to knock the handles off the top, I need to cut off the valves, and I need to punch a 3.5-inch hole in each one. And I happen to have a 3.5-inch hole saw, so I'll do that on my trusty drill press here. Let's get set up and see what we can do. All right, first thing we're going to do is take this thing off of here. And what you'll find is there are some little spot welds that hold the handle on. If you take a chisel, you get behind there, they'll break right off. See, there's one. And this is a pretty soft tank, so I may end up punching a hole in it, but it really doesn't matter because we're gonna cut a 3.5-inch hole in the top of it anyway. When you get that off, we'll move on to the next step. Now we gotta cut off the valve, everybody's favorite. Let's make some sparks. I'll show you my fancy drill press table lifting and lowering mechanism here. Because this didn't come with any kind of a screw mechanism to raise it and lower it, I use this really nice little quite expensive chain operated hoist, and it works very, very well for what I'm doing, and I can let it down. Obviously it's easier with two hands, so I'm going to set this down and we're going to get that jug on here and get it ready to drill a hole in it. Actually bore, because it's bigger than an inch. Okay, I put a strap around it and strapped it to the pipe in the back of the drill press, and there's some wood shims back here to keep it the right distance from the wood press or drill press. We're going to take this critter right here and we're going to run it right down into this thing very slowly and methodically until we get a really nice hole. And after we get that hole, then we're going to turn this a little bit and we're going to come down through and drill another hole relatively close to it. Here's what they look like now. We got this one with two holes in one end. There's a little tab sticking out here, but I'll take care of that when I get ready to put it together. It's not a big deal. Then the other tank, I knocked off the handle and drilled a hole, bored a hole down the top, and bored another hole here on the side. And you'll understand how this all works here in just a moment when I put it all together. The next trick is to cut the pipes the way I want. I'm going to have to put a door in this one here, and yeah, I'm barefoot right now, but I'm not working, I'm just making video. And and then we'll get on to the actual building of the stove. So, there we go. Tanks are ready for welding. pipe ready for cutting, and we'll call that our next video and get this one in the can. Ken Bacon. Bye for now.